All right, the Trip Trap Bar, the Bronx, early evening.
This whole thing is complete bullshit, and always has been. I mean, what's his job, really?
To keep shit from reaching the Woodlands. Jack, I don't know where they are.
You're a bar. You're supposed to have darts around.
And I normally do, but who knows where the fuck they went to after...
Come on, Holly. I need entertainment. This'll do.
Okay, I know. Just relax. I'm not here to start anything.
Yeah, it's not gonna be like last time, guys.
Okay.
Miss White, I heard you had kind of a strange morning.
It's been kind of a strange morning for everyone, I think.
Every time I see this guy, he seems to lose weight. It's amazing. It really is. He loses weight and yet somehow keeps all the muscle.
Jack.
Wolfie, my dear, how are you? Because, you know, we were just talking about you. All of us. At the bar, here. About you.
I just need to talk to Holly. Privately.
All right, just give us a second first. I'm dying to hear about the body that came out of the East River this morning. It was a fable, right? Oh, everyone knows.
Tweedledee was just here.
He said it looked like Snow White.
You sure it wasn't Tweedledum?
Well, no, but he seemed pretty sure.
Crane.
Sorry.
Tweedledee said you arrested him for no earthly reason. Kept him locked in the cellar all fucking night. He said you tortured him. Which, I don't know, that seems like a breach of your legislative duties. Bigby, come on. You can't be so dumb as
Jack,
to-
Jack, find the off button, now!
What is it with you two? You and Gran are all, let's get a posse together when there's no one around. But as soon as the big bad wolf walks in, your tails go between your legs. Cat got your nerve? What happened?
What happened? I'm tired is what happened.
Tired of what?
Of trouble, Jack. I'm sick and tired of trouble. I don't want any more.
Holly.
What?
Bigby, look. Two fables are dead. And shit, Gren's sister...
Holly's sister.
Holly's sister has been missing for what? A few days now? And we haven't heard word one about it from anyone.
Actually, have there been any updates? On my sister?
I don't know how to say this to you, Holly. The woman we found in the river.
Who was it?
You know who it was.
Boy, I sure walked into that one.
If you say one more fucking thing, just one more thing. God fucking damn it. Of course, the dear princess, Snow fucking White, is all safe and sound. Where were you when we reported this weeks ago, huh? Where are you when we ever fucking need you? If you'd give 1 ounce of a shit about her, about any of us, she might have been saved. She might have been cared for. She might have been... I'm sorry, Holly. I'm sorry we found your sister this way, and I wish this had ended up better.
Holly.
Get the fuck out of my bar.
I just want...
It should have been you. It should have been you, and it wasn't.
We recovered this from her personal effects. I thought you might like to have it.
I didn't know she still had this. The copper was from a dwarf mine.
That was decent of you.
Gren.
Yeah?
Take off for a bit, would you?
Are you sure?
I don't know that much about her life. Honestly, we didn't talk often. She was lost here, in the city. She just got swept away by it.
Why were you two not talking?
It seems so fucking petty now, but I didn't want to watch it with her. I think she was off the Monday drugs, but she was hooking to pay down debt. It ate me up to see her that way. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the Puddin' and Pie. The owner, Georgie, with all his fucking fees, it's a crock of shit. That's how they kept her under their thumb, really.
I wonder if that's our next lead.
Holly, it's okay. If it's too much, we don't have to do this.
Georgie. What do you know about him?
We can just go talk to him. We've got a lead. Maybe we can take it from here.
Lily.
Thanks for everything, Holly. Is there anything we can do to...
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy and I don't need charity.
It's not charity. It's looking out for our own.
Is she? Where is she?
She's at the business office. She's taken care of.
I'm gonna have to go down there and get her. Fuck.
Please, we can handle the funeral arrangements.
No. It's a formality with trolls. We burn our dead by sunrise or, I don't know, some old world shit will fuck your soul up.
Of course.
Okay. Good.
Let's go down to the business office and start making the necessary preparations, all right? That club?
I'll go down there now. See what I can find out from the owner.
You were good with her. I'm impressed. Really, thanks. It just made everything easier.
So we promised the body to Holly. I think that's a good call. That means that we won't be able to examine it any further, but I think we want to get Holly on our side here. Alright, the Pudding and Pie, the Bronx.
Oh, Sheriff, what a nice surprise. I'm not sure I've seen you here before. You're always welcome, of course. Is it business or pleasure?
I'm looking for someone.
Finding you someone is our specialty. But the club's closed.
Not quite what I meant.
That's too bad. I guess you'd better talk to Georgie. You're in luck. He's
all right, sounds good.
Come on.
Well, that was easy.
I should warn you that Georgie does not like to be bothered when he's working. And he's in kind of a mood right now. I mean, more so than usual.
It'll be fine. I have a way with people.
So I've heard. welcome to the Pudding and Pie, where we cater to the diverse tastes of the Fable community. Your pleasure is our pleasure. Your desires are our desires.
Listen, you could be in danger.
Oh, sweetie, we're all in danger.
All right, well, I tried.
For fuck's sake! What do you think you're doing? You look like you're trying to take a shit. Who's gonna want that? No one's gonna want that. You fucking dozy bitch.
Nice guy. Seems like a real
bitch. Oh, yeah.
You do have a sense of humor. That's good. Good luck.
All right, here we go.
It's your face. You have to smile. You never smile. Oh, it's you. We're closed. Keep dancing, you. I didn't say stop. You, stay right there. Don't even think about sitting down. We're not finished.
Leave her alone, asshole.
Sure, whatever you say.
Wow, he actually listened.
What do you want, then? You here for a little taste? Tell you what, come back after midnight, maybe. I can hook you up. Or, knowing you, she's probably not quite your style. You'd prefer someone who can take a bit of a beating. Tell me, do you prefer a stationary target or one that will put up a fight? I can arrange whatever you like for the right price.
You don't know me.
You don't know me. Okay, mysterious lone wolf, right, I gotcha. Jesus, Bigby, you're so corny. I love it, though. No, seriously, I love it. Okay, all right, Sheriff. Just fucking with you. Look, I know why you're here.
Are you sure?
Listen, Sheriff. Around here, we can't afford to wait for you and your swanky pals to take an interest. We have to look out for each other. When shit happens, I hear about it. Especially if it concerns my livelihood.
In that case, I assume you knew Lily was glamoured.
Of course she was, you daft git. She was a troll.
No, I mean glamoured to look like another fable.
Yeah? Well, so what? Who gives a toss? People get up to all kinds of things when nobody's watching. It's their own business.
I think you're behind this. You got her a black market glamour as part of some twisted sex fantasy.
Ooh, black market, is it? How exciting. This is exactly what I would expect from a thug like you. Storm in, throw around a bunch of accusations, try to scare people. But you've got fuck all to back it up. And we're all just meant to jump any time the wolf shows his teeth. He used to be something, you know. Now look at him.
Nothing to back it up? Well, what the fuck is this, then?
Get that out of my face.
I found it on Lily's body, and it's definitely a back alley job. Where did she get it?
You've got this all wrong. If Lily was doing a special glamour, it wasn't for me. For fuck's sake, I want that kind of eat.
Who was she doing it for, then?
She had clients, Bigby. Maybe one of them was into it. A lot of fucked up people in Fabletown.
Like who?
Try looking in the mirror. Anyway, now what to do with me? Go on, then.
We're not done here.
I think we are.
I said we're not.
You're gonna hit me? Go ahead. That's what you wanna do, right? That's what you came here for, right? That's what you like.
One more time. Who hired her?
Oh, no, fuck!
Awesome, and we didn't even have to punch him.
You! Take your sad fucking face where I can't see it. Bloody bastard fucking shit. You proud of yourself, mate? Proud of your little mess? Fuck's sake. Fuck off, Hans.
Hold on a minute. Hans, is it?
Hans just cleans up and provides a little muscle when we need it. He's not gonna know anything about the girls and their clients or any of that. No one knows. Don't you get it? It's by design. Discretion is our guarantee, right? And the way we guarantee that is that no one knows anything they don't have to know, including me. I cover my eyes and take my cut. End of story.
Why not look it up?
What's that?
Isn't there a little book with all the stuff about the girls and all that written in it?
You're a fucking moron!
Show me.
There is no book. And as for you, Hans, we need to work on your communication skills and have a fairly good idea where to start.
Hey, that's my personal property. Sure, go ahead. Do what comes naturally.
Tell me about the book.
You haven't got the slightest clue about anything.
Hey, now!
Cut the crap, Georgie. I want the book Hans is talking about.
Hans is confused. Again. Don't even think about it.
Yeah, we're not gonna destroy anything.
Look, Georgie, why don't you just tell me where the book is?
Can we please not go round and round about this? There's no book. End of story. Do not touch that. You hear me? That's nothing to do with you.
There's still time for you to just cough it up.
I'm sorry, Sheriff, but there's no Andy Magic book with everything you want to know jotted down inside. I sincerely wish there was. Maybe it would get you off me back.
Well, well, what's this? Looks like a floor safe.
I wouldn't know. It was here when we moved in. I don't have a key to it. Sheriff, will you come on? Fuck's sake, I've got to open up in a few hours.
Come on, Georgie.
Give it to me.
You're a big bad bastard. We get it. Everyone's guilty. We fucking get it. Jesus, you're killing me. I'm begging you. I'll pay you.
Two women are dead.
Then quit being a bloody idiot. Come on, mate. Leave it. There's nothing there for you.
You might want to stand back.
All right, all right, all right.
Now that wasn't so bad, was it, Georgie?
Bloody come on, then! Prick.
I heard that.
Once again, don't get your hopes up. There's nothing in here that'll tell you anything. But it's a kick to the balls for me and my club, so we can be happy about that.
I am happy, alright. So we got the book.
Here. This is Lily's last entry. So tell me, Georgie, who's this Mr. Smith?
Oh dear. I'm afraid it might be a fake name, Bigby. Secrecy is sort of how this all works. Even Hans knows that.
What's 207? Room number?
I don't fucking know. Millimeters, maybe?
Don't bullshit me, Georgie. This is your book, your girls.
I'm not their fucking secretary. I give them a stage, I give them music, I provide an erotic venue to attract and retain clients. But let's be clear on something. The girls make the arrangements with their clients, not me. The girls. They're the ones with the Mr. Smiths and Joneses and Mr. X types. Whatever happens outside the club, that's on them. I log the business, take my cut, and I'm out. Now, I've had quite enough of you and your bullying. Excuse me while I call your superiors to make a complaint.
Alright, you do that, man. I want to check out this mysterious door that opened.
Hello? Business office.
Alright, let's hear his complaint. Floor exam,
yeah, that's
okay,
right.
Let's... Should we take his money?
58.
No, I don't think we're gonna steal from him.
I want to talk to the deputy mayor.
He's already expecting the worst out of us, so I really don't want to give it to him. I don't want to prove him right.
I don't give a rat's ass about Georgie. That. Just fuck off and fetch him for me, all right?
Georgie.
All right, let's try one more time. Yeah, he's not having it. Okay.
No, I don't want to.
Okay, so we can go through that door. Or...
Fine, I'll hold.
What else can we do here? Okay, cool. Let's head through that door.
What's that?
Actually, hold on. We got some stuff in our inventory. So we got the glamour cylinder.
Porgy. It's Georgie Porgy.
Georgie Porgy, that's his name. Okay. Appointment book. Hold on. Can't we open this?
Well, I wouldn't be calling if it wasn't important, would I?
Okay, maybe not. Maybe that girl opened the door for us. Okay, so we got cosmetics. We got a note. Can take a look at the cubby. Lily, okay. Ooh, this is Faith's.
Lock's been busted open.
Okay.
Broken open, but there isn't even a lock.
Okay, that's strange. Let's take a look at the note.
Faith, thanks for covering for me tonight. Let's talk before you go over to the apartment. Lily. Looks like they both saw one of Lily's clients.
Okay, interesting.
Lipstick, lip gloss, compact, glitter. Faith.
All right, let's see what else we can find.
Excuse me.
I heard you out there. I don't remember ever seeing you here before.
Somebody else said that to me on the way in.
I guess we're all surprised.
Oh, she has that same ribbon as Faith.
You're trying to place me. They used to call me the Little Mermaid. Once upon a time. Does that help?
What do they call you now?
Whatever makes them happy. My name is Nerissa.
Well, Nerissa, I've got some questions.
Of course you do. I don't have answers. You'll have to find those yourself.
Did you see Lily last night? You know, where she went or who she was with?
We can't talk about work.
This is a murder case.
I mean, can't. These lips are sealed. Discretion is our guarantee. It's how things work here.
People keep using those phrases. What does it mean? This is what I need to know about. Lily's last entry. Who's Mr. Smith? Where's room 207? I have to know.
These lips. Sheriff Wolf, would you like to make an appointment with me?
What exactly are you suggesting?
We could make all the usual arrangements. The usual place.
Okay, so is she trying to tell me that she wants to give me answers? Yeah, this is a bit strange here.
Okay. What would I need to do?
I need 150. It's not good to be short.
Okay, I have like zero. Yeah, we're broke.
I'm kind of broke.
Wait here for a second.
Okay.
Not 207?
You'll think of something.
The open arms. This is where they met.
Enjoy your stay. I hope you find what you're looking for.
Sup, officer?